Well, we had to take a minor detour back to the Gaul encampment, but I know the way to go, and I will now go there. You are watching me play video games. I'm probably going to stick with Tat for the most part, at least until I get Mail's next weapon. Because honestly, the boomerang kind of sucks. The reason it sucks, I didn't really elaborate much on it in the last video. But you see how when Tat's jumping, you know, he can shoot. And it's fairly easy to control, like, the height at which he shoots and everything. Well, with Mail, with the boomerang, you can jump, and it kind of takes a second to throw the boomerang, and it makes it a lot harder to jump and aim. So, even though his armor isn't as good, bullshit, I think I'll stick with Tat for now. Just for a while. But pretty soon we'll be getting character number 3. Right after we defeat Garadus. Who's really a pushover. Well, he's not a pushover, but actually, I think I want to go up here because I think I might have missed something. No. Maybe. Guess not. Anyway, Garadus isn't that hard. He's not as hard as the Golem, anyway. That's the boss by which I judge the difficulty of all of the early bosses. So, the boss might suck, but at least it's not the freaking Golem. I hate that boss.
Teacher, what happened? You just abandoned me!
Oh, Tat. It's a long story.
If you want to tell me, I'll listen.
I was offered a big reward to guard these caves for a very mysterious man. And well, seeing how I've got a price on my head, well, it seemed like a great place to hide out. But I guess I really underestimated the power and the resolve of these pesky flying blobs. They learned of my plans for the area and, well, they got kind of angry. Squat fools, they trapped me in my sleep! But they underestimate me! Only I control Garadus! I'll crush them when I get out of here!
Well, he sounds perfectly, completely sane. Dot, dot, dot. Okay, now that we have proof that Muttonhead's going to do something stupid, I think now Gaul will listen to us. Even though he should have just listened to us in the first place, because we're the freaking heroes. You're supposed to listen to the freaking heroes. Whoa. If you get stuck on an edge like that, you can't attack. Whoa! Stupid skeletons. God, I hate them. I'm going to just destroy them all. Oh well. At least we're near a healing facility. A place of recovery. A hospital, if you will. Even though it's really a weapon shop. I'll do that first, and then it's down to talk to Gaul. Hi, I'm Gaul. Nice to meet you. This is my buddy Gaul. This is my other buddy Gaul.
This is the fool that caused Garadus to awaken! You know him, don't you? Tell, Gaul!
I'm sorry, I don't understand. What are you talking about?
Your friend has awakened Garadus from his sleep! You must pay for his
awakened? What stupid actions? I'm afraid this is making less and less sense.
This fool! Gah!
Hi! Guess what? And I know this is gonna make your day. I blew it again! Well, you see, there was this weird door in the cave, and I kind of thought that there was, well, treasure on the other side of it, you know? So I just blew the door off its hinges and, well, kind of woke up this giant. We're talking king size here, and he was pretty mad. So I just ran. Then I tell Squirty here about it, and he goes ballistic on me. I mean, jeez! So then I said, hey, God, settle down, no worries. I know this hot magician that'll shred this Garrotus dude to ribbons. But Mr. Slick.
Now that we're in this mess, you are the only hope for God Cave. You must defeat Garrotus. If you do, I'll be your friend forever. Gah.
Did he just call Tato hot? I seriously think there's something going on between those two. Anything else?
I got one last piece of advice for you.
Give him hell for the Slickster!
Mr. Slick, I will try hard to defeat Garrotus, but in the meantime, please reevaluate your behavior. Yeah, sure, Tat. I'll get right on it. Oh, how do I get myself into these situations?
I'm going to start saying that to people who piss me off. Listen, mister, you really need to reevaluate your behavior. Dang it. Oh, I should have saved first. I am the gatekeeper of the great Garrotus. So it's not even Garrotus himself. Let us save our game. Garrotus is not to be disturbed. This is another one of those bosses where you have to stay off the screen for the most part. You can't really see him that well. First we have to take care of these little goobers, which aren't hard, even though they take forever to kill. Man, I can't wait till you get the item that gives you unlimited ammo. Oh wait, there isn't one. And got lots of good hits in on him. Yes, you're stuck with this ammo limitation through the whole game. It's kind of a bummer. But it could be worse. It could, I don't know. I guess it could not give you any weapons at all. That'd be worse. This is an excellent place to use the lightning staff. Or whatever it's called. I like most of the music in this game. Not a big fan of the boss music. I don't know why. A little too repetitive. Game has great music overall, though. Okay, took care of the hench dragons. Now time to slay the beast himself. Which involves staying way, way back. That was close. That was close, too. I hope you guys realize that in order to record these, I have to turn my ceiling fan off, which means that I'm sitting here sweltering every time. Oh, every single time. Let's see if we can get close enough to see what this thing really looks like. I guess that's it for the most part. Ow! Okay. Time for a pick-me-up. And we're out of arms. Uh-oh. I better hurry this up. I don't think there's a cutscene right after this, so... Ow! I should be okay. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. Maybe it'll heal me. Kick the Thunder Dragon's butt. Come on, heal me. Don't be a douchebag. I'm not dead. I'm not dead. 100 health. Not dead. Shit!
Check, please.
Alright. See you guys next time on Let's Play Popful Mail, when we will defeat the Thunder Dragon for real. Even though we defeated him for real this time. The game freaking cheated us. Oh well.